Hey guys, we are headed to a no cooling call. It's actually like the third one I've had in the last couple of days. But this one I went out to at the beginning of winter. I'll see if I can find a link to that video. And it's a mobile home system. Filthy evaporator pool. It had leaks and problems with the thermostat wire. I gave them an estimate to correct all that. And here we are again, going back to the same address. Let's see what we find. Off the road. This weather is supposed to bring some tornadoes throughout the eastern part of the country today and maybe tomorrow, but I hope we're spared that kind of weather tomorrow. Let's see what we find. Alright guys, now on this one, I also diagnosed some airflow issues under the house. And they have good airflow on one side and poor airflow on the other. Somebody has changed that coil. Putting out some heat off the top of the coil. Come on, Measure Quick does this to me. Head pressure's climbing. Let's see what happens. Suction pressure is high. That thing's just going up. I think it's eventually going to cycle off. my supply dry bulb is, wait a minute. I'm only getting 5 degree temperature difference. That makes me think a heat strip or something is on. I haven't recovered much in that on. It was almost 500 PSI and I'm already down to 246. At 80 degrees, that superheat should be high. Was a heat strip stuck on.
Yeah. single pole.
Right.
I can do that with a... It's not overflowing. That pin's got a crack in it. Can y'all see a little crack? It goes right to the corner. Sorry about the abrupt ending on that one. I basically told them that they should not run the air conditioning and fix the heat on that. So whoever installed that coil, I advised the property manager that they should replace it under warranty. And if they don't, maybe I'll get the job. We'll see. But thanks for watching, guys. And I'll catch y'all on the next one.